why Kaman is unveiling this week a medium-lift unmanned quadcopter meant to solve the biggest challenge to the Marine Corps' Expeditionary Advanced Base Operations concept, resupplying small units of Marines scattered around island chains. Kaman's KARGO unmanned aerial vehicle has been designed from scratch over the past 9 months to meet the Marines' needs for an Unmanned Logistics Systems-Air ULS-A medium-lift vehicle for the distributed laydown the Marines expect will be the hallmark of their operations in the future in places like the Pacific, the Baltic Sea or other contested areas. The vehicle will be able to balance range and payload capacity up to 500 nautical miles and as much as 1,000 pounds of KARGO to help the Marine Corps move beans, bullets and band-aids, or even potable water, fuel and spare parts, to small units in remote locations. Kaman is the company behind the K-MAX heavy lift AV that saw operations in Afghanistan in 2011. The Marines very progressive, as they've always been, leveraging technologies. It was in theater, did a whole bunch of missions, tons of hours, basically taking young Marines off the road to move supplies around theater in the air instead of in ground convoys susceptible to being shot at or hitting roadside bombs, Walsh said. After that war ended, the Marine Corps mothballed both those helicopters because nothing really was going on, and then here we are 10 years later with this emerging threat in the Pacific Rim, he said, adding that the threat of conflict with China creates urgency for the Marine Corps and the Joint Force to figure out how it would sustain forces in a fight across such a large swath of sea space. Kaman has already completed demonstrations with a half-scale model that focused on the drivetrain and air vehicle design, and Dave Malky said several lessons came out of that that informed alterations to the full-scale vehicle. The autonomy package the AAV uses, under development by Near Earth Autonomy, is being tested separately on surrogate aircraft now. Command and control systems for various delivery options, such as conformo pods, sling loads or even airdrops are being developed by 3M Hammer. Full demonstrator will be going through ground-based testing. Flight tests of that air vehicle will begin early next year, and after an integration effort with the autonomy package and mission systems, a complete system in air test should occur by late 2022. Everything about the design is tailored to those principles, all four rotors are interchangeable, and all the blades within the rotors are interchangeable, for example, reducing the need to keep many spare parts on hand. The engine is fuel efficient, and available today, Walsh said the hope is to eventually upgrade to an electric or hybrid power system to reduce or eliminate its dependence on jet fuel, but that technology isn't mature enough yet. A gas-powered engine lets Kaman field this product in a year or two without waiting on any major technology development.